Here at CDOT, we develop new ideas to innovate and improve processes. New ideas allow our organization to reach larger goals through advancing efficiency and ensuring a safer environment for both CDOTers and the traveling public. This video is part of a mini-series that encourages you, fellow CDOTer, to implement everyday ideas into your workflow and possibly spark ideas of your own. Each video showcases an innovation submitted through our Lean Everyday Ideas program. So sit back and tune in to learn about these highlighted innovations that have proven to be successful. CDOT has historically used 1D hydraulic modeling to analyze and understand how the natural environment interacts with the build environment at bridges, culverts, and other infrastructure during flooding events. Brian Varella and his Region 4 team have helped CDOT save money and increase efficiency by opting to use a more detailed and comprehensive 2D hydraulic model for some of their projects. Let's connect with Brian to learn more about how this innovative technology has helped CDOT excel.
So we build things in the built environment and we have to interact with nature. And one of the things that we do to make sure that our design is accurate, safe, and efficient is to put it into a computer model to find out exactly how that's going to interact. The computer model that we've been using since the 1970s has been a 1D hydraulic analysis. And one-dimensional means exactly what it sounds like. You're only really thinking in one direction. One of the benefits of a 2D model is, first of all, it doesn't just look upstream or downstream, it looks left and right. And the other benefit is it reduces the assumptions that need to go into the analysis. So for example, in a 1D analysis, you have to guide the model in understanding where the flow direction should be going from the beginning. 2D analysis doesn't do that. So what it does is it reduces the potential for user-induced error. If you go back to the 2013 presidentially declared disaster, we had a series of floods. And the communities near Interstate 25 and near US Highway 85 were actually separated by the South Platte River as it was flooding out of its banks. The State Highway 60 bridge over the South Platte River, which was the largest river in my region, was ready for repair. It had fallen to a point of functional service where it needed to truly be replaced. So during my 2D analysis exploration of that project, I found if we could raise the highway just another 5 inches, we'd be able to have safe dryland access between Interstate 25 and US Highway 85 in northern Colorado. And that's the first link that CDOT was able to, during the design process, realize a safety enhancement. But when you look at, for example, same river, State 144 on the South Platte River near Orchard, we were able to actually cut the cost of those improvements in half. We needed to protect a roadway. And the 2D hydraulic analysis was able to really focus in on the critical part of the roadway, give us a detailed feedback on how water was interacting with our road, and we changed materials. We went from rock to turf mat. And that small change took a $4.1 million project, turned it into a $2.1 million project. So we've seen in the last 3-4 years of using the same technology at CDOT, that a 2D hydraulic analysis has made our projects safer, more efficient, and more cost-effective. And we're seeing right now on the order of about $14 million worth of savings just by using this technology. So when I talk about a 2D hydraulic analysis, what I'm really talking about is a software program. We make a computer model of not just sections, like dozens of cross-sections for a river, but now we're talking tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of points. So I have a more granular understanding of what's going on in my river, my bridges, my roadway, my culverts. And now we're creating infrastructure that the public can rely on, that we know is safe. It meets our operational resiliency objectives. And it actually saves money that we can move forward to the next project for the public. So we end up putting more work into the roadway and the transportation system that we're working on.
CDOT's use of 2D hydraulic modeling is a great example of how adopting innovative technologies helps us improve our approach to solving problems. Innovations like this not only save CDOT money, but also help us ensure that our bridges and roads are durable and safe. If you'd like to borrow this innovation or submit your own, you can find more information on our Lean Everyday Ideas website. Be sure to check out the rest of this LEI Spotlight video series to learn about some of the other amazing improvements that CDOT employees have put into action.